since that day he has been indwelling men and women.
Amen.
All over the earth.
Yes.
The commemoration becomes to remember the death and passion of your son, Jesus the Christ.
Thank you.
To remember that he took our sins there on the cross.
Thank you.
Hung, bled, and died to fulfill the law. That we might have life and have it more abundant. Abundant life meaning everlasting life. And for that we are indeed grateful. Now, Lord, as I, your humble servant, stand behind this sacred desk, I still come saying I don't know anything. I have no power except that you empower me to speak. But I do come, Lord, to be used by you. And then, God, when you speak through these weak lips of clay, open our ears, help us to listen. Open our eyes and let us see Jesus. We desire to see Jesus. It's in his name that we pray. And together the people of God said again, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Pastor Lewis, I want to thank you for all of your kindness. Thank you for your friendship. May I call your attention now to Paul's first letter to the church at Corinth. 1 Corinthians chapter 11.
Amen.
I don't know what turned on this faucet this morning, but it was almost out of
here. The day after Jesus' ascension.
that the apostles went to the upper room. And there they waited. And there they tarried, waiting for the coming of the Holy Ghost. And the Holy Ghost came like a mighty rushing wind. Fell upon them, and they went into the street, and they act, some said, like drunk men.
All right.
But they had not been drinking.
Yes, sir.
By the power of the Holy Ghost, they spake in unknown tongues. Once a year, we take time to remember. It's good to be able to remember. The ability to remember is a wonderful gift given to us by God. Amen.
Amen.
Everybody is not able this morning to remember. Someone went to bed last night with a good memory. But when they woke up this morning, the clothes beside the bed were strange to them. They lost their memory. Memory allows us to do extraordinary things. With memory in a flash, we can go back to our childhood. Amen.
Amen.
With memory, I can be a child all over again. Just sit there and remember playing in the crawfish ditch. I can remember down on my knees shooting marbles. God knows I remember my mother saying, if you don't get up off your knees, I'm going to. Amen. And then I would slip and get on my knees and shoot those marbles. She would see my pants knees and say, you've been on your knees again. No, ma'am. Boy, you're wearing the jeans out. I can't buy clothes and you're down on your knees shooting marbles. Oh, I remember. Some of you remember.
Amen.
You ever make a cot? You're a child again. I can remember not having any glue. But slipped in the kitchen and got me a little flour. Put a little water in it and made my own glue. Found some newspaper from somewhere and went out in the bushes and got me some sticks. Amen. All I needed was a string. I made my kite. And then I had sometimes what's called a poor man kite. A skeeter hawk. Anybody ever had a skeeter hawk? There were those who would line up their dolls and have school. Anybody ever did that? Teaching those dolls. Oh, memory is so good sometimes. It allows you to go back and be a child again. Memory can allow you to fall in love all over again. Even though you've been married for 50 years, memory can take you back to that first day. Memory, for those of us who have children who've gone on to another part of life, we can have a moment of memory and our children can be small again. Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
Some of our memories are happy memories. Yeah. And then sometimes our memories are sad.
Yeah.
Memories are also practical. Mm. Amen.
Yeah.
Practical. It's good to remember that you can't swim around a deep body of water. Because it would be sad for you to jump in not knowing that you can't swim.
My Lord.
I have a grandson, bless his heart. When he was small, his memory failed him. I happen to know that the stove is hot. And the young man, bless his dumb heart, put his hand on that hot stove. And you know what he did, don't you? He cooked it. Memory, practical. It's good. It's good. It's good to remember when you get down there at 158 and 45 to know what that red light is for. Lord, I don't remember what that red light's for. The problem is sometimes memory fails us.
Alright.
It really, I'm not talking about that time when you play like memory failed. Talk about that subjective memory.
Yeah.
Moses did as God commanded him to do.
Yeah.
in slavery. But finally, Moses tells the Egyptian officials that this is what the Lord said.
Yeah.
About midnight, I will go through Egypt.
Yeah.
Every firstborn son in Egypt will die.
Alright.
There will be a loud cry. There will be a loud wailing throughout Egypt.
Yeah.
Worse than ever before. Then God gave instructions to the Israelites. Each family is to choose a year old lamb.
Yes, yes.
One without spot.
Yes.
One without blemish.
Yes.
The best of the flock.
Yes.
And you know, church, one thing we have forgotten today is that we are supposed to offer our very best to the Lord. Give up your best.
Give up your best
to the Master.
Yeah.
Somebody asked, why do we dress up on a Sunday? We dress up because we're going to the house of the Lord.
Yeah.
And I want to give the Lord my very best.
Yeah.
I'm not going to reach in my closet and get the worst looking something that I walk around the house every day in.
All right.
I'm not going to wear my fishing clothes to church. Amen. I'm going to the Lord's house.
Yeah.
I'm going up to worship.
Yeah.
I'm going up to be in the presence of the Lord.
Yeah.
So I'm going to give him my very best.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Yeah.
God told them, kill the lamb, drain the blood in a basin, roast the lamb.
Yeah.
But before you eat it, take a bush of hyssop.
Yeah.
And dip it in the blood.
All right. Yeah, yeah.
Hang it on the lintel of the door.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Cross the door. And then on both sides of the door.
Yeah. All
right.
Amen. And he said, when I come, and I see the blood,
yeah,
I'll pass over.
Yes, sir.
All right.
All right.
All right.
All right.
But those that didn't have the blood,
yeah,
the firstborn died.
Yeah.
Right, right.
And it was the firstborn of both man and animal.
Yeah.
And that were wailing in the night.
Yeah.
But when I see the blood,
yeah,
I will pass over.
Yeah, yeah.
God said, this is a day you are to commemorate.
Yeah.
In other words, this is a day you should never forget.
Yeah.
I want you to teach it from generation to generation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That I passed over,
yeah,
Egypt, and you were spared.
Yeah.
Over 3,500 years have passed since that day. And every year, faithful Jews still celebrate. They still remember.
Amen.
The Passover.
Yes.
We got here today through the Passover.
Yes. Yes.
But then at the celebration of the Passover, that was a meal,
yes,
of remembrance.
Yes. All right. Yes, yes, yes.
Finally, there's a meal of commemoration. It was the night before the crucifixion.
Yes.
Jesus met with his disciples in the upper room to celebrate.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's it.
That's what they were going to celebrate. They were going to celebrate the Passover.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah.
It would be an evening of remembering. God had long ago commanded, but as they partook of the meal, Paul says in the text, Jesus took bread.
Yes, all right. That's it. Come on.
And when he had given thanks, He broke it.
Yes.
And he said, this is my body.
Yes.
My body.
Which is broken for you.
Yes.
Do this in remembrance. Before yourself.
Yeah.
You see, the purpose of the Lord's Supper, the purpose of the Holy Communion, is not just to remember what the Lord has done for us.
Yeah.
But also for us to get right with Him.
All right, all right.
Somebody put it in the words of the song that said, get right with God.
Yeah.
And do it right now.
Yeah.
Get right with God.
Yeah.
He will show you how.
Yeah.
He won't leave you to yourself.
Yeah.
But He'll show you how to get right with God.
Yeah.
And when you do that,